Hi, today's topic would be streamlining development with CI/CD. I will talk about how the benefits you can get and show a template product which introduces some best practices. So this talk will basically covers four parts, like how we do CI/CD internally and what kind of tools we develop for CI/CD purposes, and how to use CI/CD in your project, and what else can CI/CD do while we're releasing the project. So this is the first part, how we do CI/CD internally. This graph is a high level overview of our internal process, like what common CI/CD process do. Every time our developers push a commit, a pipeline including static code analysis and build jobs, test jobs will be triggered. If the deadline is passed, the commit will be merged into our main branch. And we also have an extra stage, which is collect test reports to monitor how the test cases goes on various of maintained versions of ESP-IDF. And this could help us improve our test coverage in our future development. When we are having a CI/CD process, we face some difficulties. The first one is that we release new target chips every year. Besides, we also need to continue to support old released chips. These kind of workflow makes our test matrix grows larger and larger. The second difficulty is that we also need to support multiple configurations. A configuration is held in a single file called SDA config, if you're familiar with ESP-IDF. This file usually modified via IDF.py menu config to customize the configuration of the project. A single project contains one configuration file or multiple of them to test with a different combination of configuration items. The third difficulty is that when we are researching what kind of test frameworks we can use, we found out that there's a lack of test framework that could interact with multiple serial devices. Some of our tests needs multiple devices interact with each other. For example, a test case that can test the Bluetooth connection between these two devices. And the last difficulty we met is that we also need to support different operating systems and different platforms. For example, operating systems, obviously, it's Windows, Linux, and Macs. And for different platforms, we have to support ESP-IDF, Arduino, and also QEMU. And recently, we are also coordinate with Walkwe, so we can, also considering supporting that. So here are the tools we developed for CI/CD. The first one is called IDF Build Apps. This is a tool to build multiple ESP-IDF applications in the CI systems. This tool is to solve the previous first two issues. Here I linked the repository, GitHub repository, and also the documentation site. You may also scan the QR code to the GitHub repository if you're interested. The second tool is also maintained by us, PyTest Embedded. This is a PyTest plugin that is designed for embedded testing. It can easily interact with Z reports, and I'll go through all the key features later. Here I also posted the repo link here and the QR code as well. First of all, let's go through the IDF build apps. Let's talk about a few concepts here. A project, which is a directory that contains all the required C files and CMake list files. And as well, there's some additional supporting elements like a partition table or data. And for the configuration, as we mentioned earlier, it is a single file, which is usually the SCA config file. And target here means our target chips. This is the hardware we established. And also the application here is the executable that is built according to the project. So as you may see, different targets and different configurations here, it generates a kind of build matrix for our test purposes. So the key features here for this tool is that it generates build matrix as the last graph. And the second key feature is that it also provides a way, which is the manifest file, for a fine-grained control over the build matrix. So in some use cases, some configurations can only be applied to a specific set of targets. For example, we definitely no need to test ESP32H2 with some Wi-Fi test apps, since ESP32H2 does not even support Wi-Fi. So with this feature, we can save both CI resources and our developers' time. And the third key feature is that this tool also supports skip the build smartly according to modified components and files. The next tool we built is PyTest Embedded. This graph shows the workflow of what does the plugin help the developers do before running the test. So this is basically about the setup phase. First of all, it would check the built binary, which is the app, and gather the app info, for example, the target, ESP32, or those configurations. And if we're testing it on QEMU, it will first merge the binaries into one single image. So QEMU will use this image, this bootable image, execute it and create a process and redirect the output of the QEMU process into our the main test process. And when we're testing it on a real target, well, we usually test it on a host machine, which connects to our ESP boards. For example, the host machines could be x86 machine or even a Raspberry Pi. So the host machine will connect it to our boards, and the PyTest embedded plugin will detect the port, the serial port connected to our board, and flash the app via the serial port, and then run the test script. It also got a few key features. The first one is it supports all the operating systems and platforms, as we mentioned earlier. And the second one is that it can run on different platforms without any code change. So basically, you don't need to modify your test scripts, not a single line, just run with different CLI parameters. I'll show you later. And the third key feature is that it will automatically set up the firmwares while set up. So the developers mainly can only like focus on the test case itself. No need to worry about which platform I'm in or which operating system I'm in. So here, this slide shows that we can use this same script to test on different platforms. This part is a very simple, basic test function, test hello world. So basically, it only expects the hello world string from the serial output or the the QEMU output. So for example, if we're running it on our Arduino platform, we can pass this with a parameter called embedded services, ESP, Arduino, different parameter will enable different modules. So internally, it will call different functions. So for ESP-IDF with real target, we can pass parameter as ESP-IDF. And with QEMU, we can pass the parameter with IDF and QEMU. Okay, so this is the third part, how to set up the CI/CD for your project. This is a release process, very simple. Like we suppose all the commits will be made in the dev branches, and the dev branches will be merged into the main branches, and only release these the main branches by tagging. So each tag represents a production release. So on the dev branches, we create pull requests. Pull requests will trigger a pipeline, which includes only build stage jobs and the test stage jobs. On tag triggered pipeline, which is the production release, it includes build stage jobs, test stage jobs, and the release stage jobs. On the GitHub actions, we can also test with real targets and test with QEMU. For real targets, GitHub also supports, we set up the self-hosted runners connected with ESP devices. So if you have some free Raspberry Pis, you can connect it with ESP devices and follow this link. This link will guide you how to add your Raspberry Pi into a GitHub runner. In this demo, we will show you how to test with QEMU. This is much simpler. Like if your project is an open source project, you can, it's free, totally free. And you can, the ESP-IDF QEMU is still in beta phase, but you can try it right now. Here, I also linked one of my repo, also the QR code here. This repo includes the QEMU Docker file and also the slides, today's slides. Okay, so now I'm going to show you a demo with the real GitHub actions. So this is the QEMU Docker file, which I created. It's based on expressive IDF Docker image, as you may see here, and it includes the latest release of our QEMU as well. Here it installs all the required runtime libraries, and that's it. It also deployed to the Docker Hub, so you may also use the link I posted earlier, Docker Hub HSU dev QEMU. And this repo is a template repo that you can use directly by clicking. Here, this workflow includes that a variety of build matrix jobs for different ESP-IDF branches and targets. And later on the test stage, it will include also QEMU test jobs, apps built by the last step. On the last step, it will also upload all your artifacts, so you may check it on the summary tab of the GitHub action as well. And on the release stage, which will be triggered on the tag pipelines, it will also publish to our component registry. This file, it's called build and test application. So here it defines a few variables and run with only C code modifications on the pull requests. This is a build jobs. As you may see here, we defined a matrix of IDF branches and targets it will run with our self-maintained Docker image, ESP-IDF. It supports all the maintained release branches Docker images. Here is first install all the required Python dependencies for build, IDF build apps, and then build the test applications with ESP-IDF. Here it calls the method and upload the required binaries. The ELF file here listed is not required. It is optional. It could help you debug when your app fails the test. And this shows the target test. The target test will be run on QEMU. Here the test matrix is as defined earlier, the same IDF branch and target. It will first download the artifacts built on the laptop, install all the required Python packages, and run the test app. Finally, it will create JUnit reports and upload the artifacts. This is the published component, GitHub Action. It will be only triggered on the tag pipelines. It will push the component to the component registry. As you hear, we also maintain the GitHub Action called Upload Component CI Action. Once this job is successfully run, we can check our uploaded component via our component registry, components.expressive.com. So other developers may also use your component, and the release is done. Okay, so the build stage includes the build matrix jobs, the text matrix job, and on the release stage, we release to the component registry. This is the workflow of GitHub Actions. And finally, what else can CI/CD do while releasing? First of all, you can sign your app with HSM. HSM is a way that we can secure our built binaries with hardware. You may also deploy your app with ESP Insights. ESP Insights is a tool that we can deploy our built binaries into network connected devices. We can also generate software bill of materials. This is a file that can show you all the dependencies. Here I also posted all the QR codes aside. And thanks for watching.